Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel, welcome to my new subscribers, and if you're new here please consider subscribing, I would love to have you. So this is the person on your mind. This could be anybody that you've lost touch with, okay, or you've fallen out with, so you take what resonates. So this is, how has their life been going since you've been gone? Do they think of you? Do they have a channel message here for you? But we'll have a look, I'm going to blag it, okay? So for group one, we have number 19 and we have Oregon's Lair. Okay. For group two, we have number 43 and we have Hotels. I don't know why I'm saying it like that. But anyway, ignore me. And then for group three, we have number 49 and it's Talisman. Okay. So you take what resonates, leave what doesn't resonate with you. If it's not your pile, choose another pile, and don't forget these are energies as well, guys. And I'll see you there. Hey group one, so if you chose Oregon's Lair, this speaks of the energy that's come through, is going through a lot of peril in their life, okay, a lot of problems at the moment. It's testing their courage. And with this card, sometimes it actually tells the person to maybe turn around and take a different path, you know, because this card does have a dragon here, which is protecting the top of this tower here. But it's whether they're willing to listen to that. They may have taken a wrong path, but yeah, this energy is, I don't think they've made a good choice in something in their life, but let's have a look. So tell me about this Oregon's Lair and the person on group one's mind. How are they doing? That says it all really, doesn't it? So we've got Five of Pentacles, which is oh shite. Nine of Pentacles, Temperance. Six of Pentacles and the Page of Wands. This energy is single, okay? They are alone at the moment. They invested in something. They may have opened up their own company, done something themselves here, or they could just be working and you know, money is really good. But I'm looking at this. I feel like they made a really bad investment here. You know, everything was running really smoothly for this energy at one time. You know, this could have been a partnership with someone where it was equal give and take. But with the Page of Wands, this energy here came up with an idea, a plan, I don't know, maybe to invest, you know, take a chance on something, and this is why we've got the oh shite card here, which is now them. They could be in poverty right now, they could have lost everything that they worked really hard for. They're experiencing some kind of financial loss, because you see here that it's really beautiful, but then you've got, tell me about this Five of Pentacles. What's happened to this person? Oh dear, game over, yeah. They're beating themselves up at the moment because they've made a bad choice, a bad investment. They've lost everything. What did they do? Tell me about this Page of Wands. Eight of Cups. They've had to leave it behind. Tell me about the Page of Wands and the Eight of Cups. Let me do that again. Oh my goodness. Okay. So we've got the Chariot, Strength, Ten of Wands, Eight of Wands, the Wheel of Fortune. They acted very quickly here without thinking. And this was a partnership. I feel like they may have gone into a partnership with somebody here, you know, or someone gave them an idea and they ran with it. And it's like they've had to walk away, they've had to leave everything that they work for. Really, you know, they really did work hard for this. I do feel kind of sorry for this energy. So whoever this is to you guys, I'm going to ask who this is to you guys. You may not know who it is right yet at the moment. Maybe you don't know what's going on in their life, but this is what's happening. They worked really, really hard. It looks like they invested into something here that it could have been someone done a runner with, because with these two right here, okay, we've got the Five of Swords, the Eight of Cups. This is theft. This is somebody that's done something to somebody else here, okay? So this is theft, and then we've got walking away. So I'm looking at these two of, you know, the two together as somebody done a runner with everything they work for. Whoever this is that they trusted, it backfired, because I'm seeing this person doing, you know, the Chariot is a vehicle, you know, getting in a vehicle and just taking off. And I'm actually seeing with this card here, and I know I shouldn't laugh with strength, because she's got the guy on her lap and she's spanking him with a paddle. And it's like, I feel like maybe this was a partner of theirs. You know that saying, you know, like a pussycat but with whip at the end, if you know what I mean. Maybe it was a partner. See, now this could have happened, but then with Oregon's lair there, this is actually telling this person that the path you are choosing right now, or you're going down, is going to be hard and difficult, and it's best to turn around and go, you know, take a different path, go a different way, choose something different here. So now they're experiencing all these problems here, you know, burdens and worry and stress, and, you know, there's a lot of communication at the moment, I feel like they're trying to maybe do something about what this person did, or maybe they're trying to find out where this person is. But their fortunes have turned for the worse. I do want to know about the Wheel of Fortune and the Lovers as well. So we do have Gemini, we do have Sagittarius, we do have Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Leo, we have Cancer. So tell me please, Spirit, about this Wheel of Fortune. That Ace of Cups, the Two of Cups, the Four of Cups in reverse. Yeah, this, I feel like a partner did something here. Why am I whispering? You know, we do have the Knight of Wands on the back of the deck, and that is somebody that is very childish, you know, somebody that's in and out of someone's life, you know, a user. So this energy, okay, could have been in a committed relationship with someone. They may have thought this was their soulmate, but, you know, I'm clarifying the Wheel of Fortune. This is a karmic soulmate that they're, obviously, to teach them a lesson. And I know that some of us get really peed off that we're like, well, you know, I'm fed up with hearing about soulmates and teaching us lessons and this, but it is what it is. But this is definitely a karmic soulmate that taught this person here a lesson, and they're trying to find some kind of mental strength here. They really are trying to get their life back in order. I mean, this person could have actually run off with somebody else. Tell me about the Lovers. They didn't heed the warnings. I feel like there was warning signs here for this person, and they did not heed any of them from Spirit. So look at that. The Lovers, the Devil, they got involved with the Empress, wow, the Ace of Pentacles, and the Two of Wands in reverse. Oh, dear. So yeah, they got involved with somebody here who was very greedy, very manipulative, maybe, you know, like mind control, telling them what they wanted to hear. This was coming from an Empress here, so, you know, this could have been their mother, father, whatever, but whoever they were involved with was an Empress, but I feel like it's a fake Empress. And look at the way she's smiling as well. And, you know, you see this card here with the Ace of Pentacles. This is moving away, this is moving abroad, this is starting anew, this is the life that you've been wanting, you know. So, I mean, I don't see divorces. I am seeing that this energy is single, but the person they were involved with has robbed them. So we have Capricorn. Tell me about, I'm just going to ask for the Five of Swords, the Star. They're healing at the moment from this. They are coming out of it. They've got no choice, basically, but they are really, really trying to manifest, trying to hope for some kind of change or a miracle here. You know, they are facing facts here that they were in a, you know, Five of Swords could have been an abusive relationship. We do have the Devil in the Five of Swords. This is somebody that is very, very, toxic. You know, maybe this person was toxic to you. So we have Aquarius energy as well. So I want to see if they think about you. Okay. So does this energy think about group one? God, blimey. No, it's too big. There's so many. Does group one cross this energy's mind? So we've got the Princess of Pentacles and the Magician. They do. They do think about you. Oh, they. Okay. Yeah, they do. They find you really fascinating still, okay? I do believe this person may still watch you or check up on you every now and again. Maybe you're not aware of that. But since you've been gone, this energy here does grieve for the loss of the connection or the relationship or friendship or whatever it was, okay? They are missing you. This is, you know, the Five of Cups is regret. Huge regret, but the thing is, they keep these emotions hidden from people. I don't feel like they tell anybody about this. This is buried. It could be that they're trying to manifest you back. Maybe, I'm not sure. Why is this magician here? Why is the magician here, please, Spirit? Ten of Swords, Four of Cups. In reverse, Seven of Swords. I feel like why their emotions and this regret is here for you, group one, okay? That there's pure regret here is the fact that they were very manipulative and very clever in how they treated you or maybe how they left your life. They know this, and I feel like this is why they keep their feelings hidden. They may have kept this a secret from other people of what they did to you, group one. You know, Seven of Swords is a sneaky energy. This is somebody that's trying to get away with something, you know, stealing, cheating, dishonesty, betrayal, you know. And this energy here, I'm a bit confused with this because with the Ten of Swords, this is rising above your haters, rising above all of your problems here. And I feel like they rise above you. Do you get me? They came out on top with this magician here because they thought they were very clever. You know, they had it all, you know, the brains, whatever. But now it's all come crashing down. So this energy did something quite cruel to you, group one. And this is like karmic justice, really, like with Wheel of Fortune, you know, turning around and, what goes around comes around. So I do believe this energy does think about what they did to you, and there is really, really, like, there's a lot of regret. Let me be nosy. Sorry, I'm nosy. What did this energy do to group one? What did they do? You're gifted, which is a special card in this deck. They took away your blessings. Do that again. Tell me about the all gifted. Oh my god. Okay. So we have the Ten of Wands. Because that's a blessing card. That's your angels there that's giving you, you know, giving you something. It could be a gift. It could be an actual, you know, where you create something, an idea that comes to you. But this is a really special card, and this energy took this from you. So this could be what, oh, did you do that? Because the Page of Wands has come up twice now. And this is coming up with ideas and blah, blah, blah. And at the beginning, okay. There is another part to this reading now where I'm seeing maybe you had an idea for something, group one, and this energy, you may have given them the idea, and that you may have thought that you were going to go in it together, you know, you were going to get the rewards after this took off, but they took off with somebody else here, or they went into business with somebody else. They took your idea that was gifted to you, not them. This is why they're receiving some kind of bad karma here, you know, what goes around comes around, because this is like, this reading is literally like for like what's happening to them. They did to you, it's happening to them now. So they started communicating with somebody else here, okay? They chose, maybe they chose another partnership, chose to go with somebody else here, but this was, I feel like this was your baby, your idea. Yeah, look, collaboration, working together with someone, you know? Working with other people, sharing your ideas, giving, you know, putting your ideas out there. And I feel like this is what this energy did. So this is a bit like a karma reading, really. Okay, I'm going to get some oracle cards. What an a-hole. So if you're wondering whether this person's gone off and lived their best life with your ideas or, you know, your support or whatever, no, no, no. They've lost it all. So a bit more about this person on group one's mind. So you know, this energy at one time, okay, but I feel like maybe this is for you though, because these cards, it could either be for this energy or your energy, but I'm feeling this might be for you. Divine intervention, perfect timing, happy surprises, a fortunate stroke of luck. And I feel that they ended up taking the luck from you that was supposed to be yours, because that's what's the all gifted card is. And now, you know, divine intervention is where the person, you know, where the, oh my goodness, I can't freaking talk, the divine gives it back to the person that it's supposed to be given to. You know, this was not yours. Coldness, absence of love, love life is blocked, frozen in some area of your life, emotions buried deep within. So this is what this is, this, oh my god. You know when you just want to whack yourself when you can't talk properly? It's like, or shake yourself, actually. I don't hit myself, okay, so don't think I do things like that, but oh my goodness, you just get so frustrated. We do so many reading that you talk too much. Let me have a drink, that might help. Right, so this energy here is experiencing coldness in their life, okay? They've got absence of love. They have been rejected, okay? They feel unwanted, they feel unloved. Somebody rejected them. Something is frozen in their life, the area of their life. I mean, and that literally will go with this card here. I don't know if you can see it properly from there, but this is all covered in ice. You know? So, Two of more. Let's rip out this energy. That's too many. Oh, sod off. So we've got mountain. Obstacles and challenges, possible delays, patience needed, requires perseverance. Yeah, and that is basically a house or a castle or something on a mountain. So we've got the hidden enemies, jealousy, hiding true intentions, being two-faced, time to work in silence. And I feel like that's exactly what they did to you, you know. I just want to get my, bear with me guys, I'm trying to get them out of the box. Something made me grab these cards because they've got quite a dark side to them. So let's say their shadow self. Deadly combo, dangerous when together, triggering and explosive. So that could have been how your connection was. False hope, tries to sell you the pipe dream. No substance, evasive. There you go. It may have even been you, group one, that may have invested in this idea, startup idea, okay, and they done a runner with the money, okay, you know, because there's so many people watching this and it could be in, you know, different scenarios here. If it was a personal reading, I could dig deeper, but it's not, okay, it's a collective reading. So, you know, for some of you, I'm picking up as well that you invested your time, your money and everything, and I feel like this person robbed you. Yeah, look at this. On the back of the deck, we've got all talk, silver tongue, devil, big flirt, no action, and a player. Right, I want to get you some oracle messages, okay? Maybe there might be something that comes out for them. So let's get you some oracle messages in regards to this situation. So you have the key, solutions and new ways, unlock doors to new possibilities. So maybe you found a solution to this, maybe you, you know, unlocked a door to maybe starting something yourself. So for group one, please, spirit. Jesus. The celestial. Connection with the universe, you are part of something bigger. Yeah, I feel like they messed with the wrong energy here, which is you, group one, that they shouldn't have done that. You know, you are treasured by spirit here with this card. This card hardly ever comes out. Yep. Oops, stay. Right, let's get a question for you. So ask a question. I think of a question. It doesn't even have to be about this. It could be about anything that you want, okay? So for group one. So we've got in a few weeks. You've come far on your journey and you will soon see what you have accomplished. Okay, that's positive. In a few weeks, spirit is saying. So that's really good. Anyway, group one, I'm going to leave it there, okay? If you like this video, please hit like. It helps. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you. And thank you for watching. Much love. Hey, group two. So if you chose hotels or tales, so with this energy of this person on your mind, this is somebody that I feel like was a bit of a perfectionist, okay, may still even be a perfectionist. They like things done a certain ways, or it could be that they are the type of person that needs to be perfect all the time, you know. Yeah, all the time this energy has to be perfect. It could also be that at the moment they may be in the process of making a commitment or signing a document. And spirit is actually trying to tell this energy here to read the fine print, you know, pay attention, not afterwards, because once they sign it, I feel like they're buggered. So let's have a look. So spirit, tap me into group two. This person on their mind. So this energy is life since they've been gone. Tell me about this. Hotels, hotels. Jeez. Yeah, look. The High Priestess. Four of Cups. Nine of Pentacles. They could be entering into some kind of marriage or an engagement here, or I want to clarify that. Now, Spirit is actually saying to them, literally, I mean, if you look at this card, it actually says clarity, important notes. It's paying attention to the fine print, you see. So it could even be like a prenup or something like that, you know, you never know. But this person doesn't tend to use their intuition here. It's like they're rejecting these messages from Spirit, you know. This could be Spirit actually trying to warn this energy here that, you know, how can I explain it? Through dreams or through signs, you know, angel numbers. But this energy is literally rejecting Spirit at the moment. Maybe they're not a believer in spirituality. They may not believe in anything spiritual. This person earns a good income. They may have their own business here, but they're about to enter either a partnership. This could be a partnership or a marriage here. Let me have a look. Tell me about this Nine of Pentacles and this Four of Wands. Page of Swords. There's a lot of gossip surrounding this energy, okay? A lot of spies. Someone's watching this energy here, and something doesn't feel right. Tell me about the Nine of Pentacles and the Four of Wands. It could have been someone was spying on them, knowing that they were doing well in life, you know. Yeah, look at this. Ten of Pentacles, Queen of Pentacles. This person's very, very well off. King of Pentacles as well. This energy has done well for themselves in life. So well. It's actually making me a bit paranoid, actually. This might be my reading. I don't want to go into too much detail. I don't think the person watches my channel. But my husband owns his own business, and person he's in partnership with is a bit dodgy. Hopefully he doesn't watch this. Maybe I should edit it out. But anyway, no, I'm not gonna. But anyway, I'm seeing something that's this is delayed at the moment though. This person has built up their career here. Like this could even be a family member, guys, okay? This could be just, you know, you may be in contact with them still, maybe you're not, you know, but this is the person that's on your mind. How is their life going? Their life is going so well. They started this career off on their own, okay? They built it up from the ground up. Now they've got generational wealth where they can leave their children a legacy here, and it will go down the generations. I mean, this energy has literally come out as a king and a queen. You know, this is a very grounded energy here. Successful. So we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. We've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius as well. It could be, God, because this is a couple as well. You know, I said at the beginning, this person could be entering into a marriage here. This is a bit complicated. Tell me about this Page of Swords. The Fool and Strength. And the Eight of Cups. Bear with me, guys. Somebody's been prying into their business here. This is quite a difficult energy to I don't know, read, if you know what I mean. It could be that maybe they've actually found out about what's going on here. This energy here, it's like somebody you don't mess with. Okay, they are a very strong energy here, and once you pee this person off, they'll walk away. They leave you. They leave you in the dirt. Okay, they won't even give you a second thought. This person has the courage to do that. But there's something here that they're going to be, it could either be not noticing spirit telling them to change direction here. So don't ignore the fine print and, you know, walk away from this situation here. It could also be that this person's not really satisfied in the connection that they're in as well. You know, they're not really satisfied with it's just not bringing them any happiness here. But I do feel like this is some kind of maybe inheritance or marriage contract or something like this that they need to be very careful of. This is what spirit's saying. Tell us more, spirit, what is going on with this energy? What's going on in their life? We do have Leo as well. Tell me a bit more. The Lovers, the Star, the Hermit. It may even be with this energy, okay, group two, that they may have, you know, when I said about the spies, okay, looking into something, watching someone, maybe they have an inkling that this person's not to be trusted, okay? We do have the Lovers here, and they are actually considering moving on and walking away here. It's like they are really thinking about this at the moment, is what is going to bring them happiness. Is this going to bring them any happiness? If it's not going to bring them any happiness, and I do feel like they have been talking to other people about this. It's still very strange though. Tell me about the Lovers. Jesus. Yeah, look at this. There we go. This is what I was looking for. Yeah, because look, we even have the Ace of Cups, okay? This is entering into a marriage. But I feel what's happened is that this energy's found something out here, and, you know, they may have a family with this person. But what I'm seeing here is there is theft, there is secrets here. There may have been bullying going on. It's just this energy just feels defeated. It's like they I feel like they really did, whoever they were wanting to marry or they are married to, Because this could be a divorce, okay, a separation here that's going on. They have walked away or they're considering it. They may be on the verge of doing it. Because this person broke their heart. What did they do, Spirit? Tell me about the Three of Swords. Three of Swords, judgment, making a decision, finding clarity. Tell me about the Three of Swords. Yeah, they were married. This person was married or was getting married. Or getting married. I'm so contradicted with this. Like, I'm all over the place with this reading. This person's brain is so confused. It's like 1 minute I'm saying yes, I'm walking away. Next minute, no, I'm staying. So this is the energy that's in the process of coming to a decision soon, okay? On whether they want to get married, whether they want to commit to this energy. But I've got a funny feeling that this is why I said at the beginning that this person is not going to listen to spirit here. They're not listening to the signs here, because this person's so desperate for that security of family, you know, having that commitment and settling down, and they don't want to let that go. You know, it could be they don't want to let the marriage go if they are married. And they're holding on really tightly, knowing that this is whatever's happened here. I do feel like there was some kind of theft or lies. Maybe what's happened here is this energy has maybe got married, okay, didn't look at the fine print, and now they're stuck. Now it's like, what do I do? Because this energy could end up taking everything from me. It could be that, you know, some people do tend to take their partner's money and put it away, if you know what I mean. You see that quite often. But let's have a look. Five of Swords. Do that again, please, Spirit. Clarify the Five of Swords. Nice. Energy's worked really, really hard, but Queen of Swords. Okay. Tell me about the Five of Swords. Six of Pentacles in reverse. Says a lot, really. It's like this. Yeah, it's over. Okay, we finally got bloody thingy here. Whatever they're going through, okay, it could be getting married or they are married, but I feel like they may be, this is over or it's coming to an end soon. Because this energy feels like they're putting in so much effort, but they're not getting anything back here with the Six of Pentacles. This Queen of Swords is somebody, I feel like it's this energy here that needs to protect themselves from everything that they've gone through, okay? They're on the, yeah, they've gone cold. They're very distant here. They're in pain as well. They've learned a valuable lesson here. It wasn't an equal relationship. This energy that they got involved with, I don't know, wasn't very nice to them. They took advantage of this Queen of Swords. This is the same energy, you know, these are energies, okay? But this is somebody that is experiencing a lot of pain. Did I say divorced? So this person could be divorced or separated. And this Queen of Swords, you know, she's actually clever, because she could see that she was being lied to. So we do have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We do have Taurus as well. So let's see if they ever think about you. So, Spirit, tell me, does this energy ever think about group two? Yeah, life's it didn't turn out the way they planned it, you know. Quite sad, really. It's over, they've moved on, they've closed this chapter, or they're going to. The moon and the four. Yeah, they've got repressed feelings for you guys, okay? They, I feel like they think about you guys too much, okay? Their emotions are like run really deep for you guys. They literally drains them emotionally at times, you know. I feel like this person just wants to forget about you. It could be the feeling of, you know, I wish I'd chosen group two, but I didn't. Tell me about the moon. So we have Pisces. Tell me about the moon. Yeah, they would like to apologize to you. This is the pain. This is why they're emotionally drained here, you know. Look, can't be, no, maybe there's no contact. This person's been away from you for a while. This may be in a quick relationship at one stage as well. They may have disrupted your life, may, you know, they may have been a bit reckless when it came to you. You were very patient with this energy here, and there is an apology. They do want to give an apology. Maybe they'll be reckless and give you one. Maybe now they realise, if they're going through all this, sometimes it can actually make you realise and bring up old wounds and people that you've hurt in the past, you know, and you start thinking about it and overthinking about it, and it's like, oh my God. So yeah, they saw you as somebody, now they see you that you were someone who was wish fulfillment, okay? You made them very happy. You wasn't greedy is what I'm hearing. I feel like they got involved with somebody who was very greedy. Look, they're in a mental prison now. Yeah, look, here we go. Divorced couple. King and Queen of Swords. When they come out, they are divorced. This is separated. They still carry the burden around of maybe losing you, of what they did to you. Who is this person to group two? Who is this energy to group two? Temperance and the Devil in reverse. Oh, wow. Queen of Cups. Okay. This is somebody that... Okay, I'm going to describe the energy to you. This is someone that overindulged in... maybe the devil's lettuce. You know, the fun stuff that people take. It could have been alcohol. It could have been, just been somebody that just went over the top. Yeah, this person, they weren't balanced when you knew them. But this energy here with the Devil in reverse is telling you that this person overcame their addictions. Became very independent, you know, from all this. This is somebody, this is Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. This is somebody who had a really loving side to themselves, okay? Very nurturing, very caring. So this could have been a parent. This could have been a sibling to you. Maybe even a friend. But I feel like this energy would have like outbursts, you know? Like they'd lose their temper pretty quickly. And I don't know why I'm seeing this person would like a glass of wine, a few glasses of wine of an evening, you know. Maybe that's where the overindulgent was. This person wasn't, they wasn't grounded at the time that you knew them. They are now. They've come a long way since then. So there is huge regret here. Huge regret, and there is this apology that they would like to give you. Maybe they will never give it to you physically, like verbally, sorry, but maybe that's why it's come through in the cards, is that they want to say, I'm sorry. So anyway, let's get some oracle cards. Let's see what else for group two, please, spirit. So we've got snake. Time of healing, shed old skin, secret knowledge, jealousy and envy. So this person, you know, could have been a snake. Um, So we've also got waiting game, waiting for something or someone, expecting to hear news, putting your life on hold, prepared, ready, and waiting. So this could mean two things, you know, like there is something delayed in regards to news with this person. They are waiting to hear some kind of news. I don't know what it is, but it could be financial. But their life is on hold at the moment. But it could also be waiting to apologise to you. You know, waiting for that right moment to do it. So everything is up in the air. Not knowing where you stand, situation, decision, still undecided, uncertain about something, lacking stability. And I said that this person, it's like I'm literally was going to and fro, like, yes, I'm going to leave, no, I'm going to stay. You know, it is the energy that this person's in at the moment. But the energy that I see right at the end there is the world, that they are going to put a stop to it. So this energy is also attracting new friends, changes in friendships, spending more time with friends, letting go of toxic friends. So they may be having a clear out. And then we have dating, being open to love, seeing somebody specific, going on more dates, feeling good and flirting. So, you know, this energy could be going out on dates, just enjoying life. So anyway, let's get you a question card, okay? It don't have to be about this person or this situation here. You can ask anything you want, guys, okay? So think of it or ask it out loud. So for group two, please, spirit. Choose a new direction. There is something better out there for you. Make a conscious choice to step into your true path, okay? So spirit wants you, whatever it was that you asked, wants you to choose a different direction. An interesting one. Okay, group two, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, please hit like. It helps. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. Thank you for watching, guys. You have a beautiful day. Much love. Hey, group three. So if you chose talismans with this energy, okay, this energy speaks to somebody that has a choice that they need to make, okay? Straight arms, freaking throat's going. Basically, this energy, whoever this is to you, group three, tends to make the same mistakes over and over and over again. And it's like spirit is saying, why would you keep making those mistakes? Have you not learned from those past mistakes? And it looks like they're on a verge of either doing it again or changing direction, because here she's got her foot on an arrow, you know. She's got a foot on this path, but then she's got a foot on this, just this arrow here that's stepping onto the grass. So let's see what this person's going through right now. So spirit, take me into group three, the person on their mind. How is this life, energy's life going right now? Ace of Stones, which is Ace of Pentacles. Tell me about this talisman and this Ace of Pentacles. Two of Cups in reverse and the Messenger of Cups, which is the Page of Cups and Death on the back of the deck. So this could be a new beginning, okay? Spirit is giving them another go, basically. Here you go. Here's another chance at doing something right this time. So it can be a new job. It could be a new relationship. It could be moving home. It could be anything. I am picking up it's to do with love, though, because we do have two love cards here. Now, this energy is not listening to spirit here. It's like, you know, even this card has got somebody standing on the top of the hill here, and there is a road, once again, a windy road. You know, maybe they feel like they've met their soulmate here. But with the Two of Cups, this is not good. They could be okay, I feel like Spirit is saying you've got a chance to go into a new beginning. I feel like this is either a divorce or a breakup here. There's no love here anymore, but maybe they're considering of staying with their partner, you know, trying to make it work. Maybe this has been an ongoing pattern in this person's life that they're not learning that nothing is going to change. You know, it could be a toxic environment. And I feel like Spirit is trying to say to them, look, give up. Move on. And you know, death is an ending, it's big changes, it's moving on from this situation. But are you listening? I don't feel like this energy is listening. There's a lot of jealousy and envy in this connection that they're in here. It could be maybe they'll end up with a lot of trouble if they were to leave. I don't know. What's going on? So we do have Scorpio. Tell me about the Two of Cups and the Messenger of Rain. You know, it could be they're the toxic one and they're not learning from past mistakes, you know. This could be a relationship you had with someone. Yeah, look. Ten of Rain, which is the Ten of Cups. This person has a family. They could be married or just in a serious committed relationship right now, but they are not happy. They are unfulfilled. They are miserable. Absolutely miserable. They thought they were getting their happily ever after. Maybe this energy jumps from one relationship to the next to the next. I don't know, but tell me more, please, Spirit, about what's going on in this energy's life right now. I feel like they're going through or considering divorce. We do have the Sun. And we have the Five of Wind that's come out like that, which is the Five of Wands. This energy, whoever they got involved with, it's like constant arguing, fighting, you know, maybe dragging other people into their problems. It's not healthy at all. And they want to heal from this. They either want to heal the relationship, hoping that they're going to be able to change things and heal things here, you know. This energy don't want me to talk. One time they were really happy, but they thought they were happy. No, I feel like they may end up going for a divorce here with justice. And it could be karmic justice, okay, for you guys. You know, maybe this is the way they treated you. Maybe they left you for somebody else, you know. But they are not having a good time here. They want a new beginning. But I'm seeing here that unless there's some kind of change, you take that step to end things and move on, nothing is going to change. It's going to just stay the same in this person's relationship here. So who is this to group three, please, Spirit? The Empress, Seven of Wands, and the Five of Cups. This is somebody who rejected you, somebody who broke your heart, somebody who may have juggled you and left you for somebody else. They may have... you felt unwanted by this person. This person made a choice. They may have left you for somebody else here. That's what I'm seeing. So this is an ex-partner. You may have even been married to this person. You may have children with this person as well. They left you on your own. They left you to go solo, to do things yourself. You know, they didn't even give you a backwards glance. But now, it's like I said, karmic justice. It's happening to them now. They're not happy. They thought they were getting their happily ever after. They're not. They're miserable. Absolutely miserable. Wow. I mean, they left you, you're the Empress, you're the Divine Feminine. They left you for what, I don't even see here what they really left you for. So, do they ever think of Group 3, Spirit? Do they ever think of Group 3? Is there any regrets? The Hierophant. So you may have even been married to this person. Ten of Wind. Sod you. That's too many. Oh, okay. Yeah, they talk to other people about you. They may even inquire, may ask other people how you're doing. But I see here with the Hierophant, that you would have made a better fit to this energy. This is what they're thinking now. You would have been the better fit. You would have been the better one to marry. I mean, come on, Empress, hello. All they got though out of their life, you know, is problems, and a lot of worry and a lot of grief. I feel like though they're trying to, I don't know whether they're trying to justify their actions or trying to maybe understand what they did to you. Maybe this, they might actually be speaking to other people, trying to work through this. This could have even been a work affair, you know, you never know. Tell me about this Ten of Wind. What are they thinking about when it comes to Group 3? Nine of Wind now, the Four of Rain, and the Three of, yeah, they miss you, yeah. Sorry. They wish they could balance things out with you, okay? They were confused, this is what they're trying to say. They were confused. They had to do what was best for them, you know? They had to make a compromise or a sacrifice, if you want to put it that way, and you were that. And they're saying that this took a lot of courage to actually leave you because, you know, they were bored in the connection with you. I know that sounds really harsh. They wasn't getting any satisfaction. I feel like there wasn't any excitement. Maybe this was a work affair that they had. But this is somebody who actually still yearns for you, yearns for what you both had. They are missing you. It's Three of Wands though, because sometimes this talks about waiting for something or someone. Tell me about this Three of Wands. Messenger of Ashes and the Hangman. Yeah, you know what they're wanting to really do here is they would like to communicate to you, you know, maybe start talking to you again, maybe even an apology, you never know. But this is somebody that would like to communicate with you, but they know they can't. They're stuck in their circumstances here. It could be that they know that you wouldn't even have, you wouldn't even let them do this. So we do have Taurus, we do have Libra, we do have Neo Aries Sagittarius as well. Yeah, there's huge regret here, okay? And I feel like with this energy as well, Group 3, they have to live with what they did, you know? Maybe they're realising it's some kind of karma as well. I feel like when they got involved with this person, they really, like, they went OTT, you know? Oh my God, I've met my soulmate, you know? I've met the one, and what happened was they met a karmic. So this energy's life at the moment is either going through a divorce or a separation. Maybe they're in some kind of couples counselling as well. I'm not a doctor, but I'm just saying, you know, trying to maybe work on the relationship, but it's not going to work. Spirit is saying this person keeps making the same mistakes over and over and over again. You know, maybe this energy falls in love very quickly. You know, that could be something that's missing within them. Let's get some oracle cards on this energy here. So tell me more about this energy. All talk, silver tongue, devil, big flirt, no action, and a player. So this is their shadow self. So we have controlling. Controlling needs to be right all the time. Possessive and a jealous lover. Others love, still involved with the past, cheating, secret affections. You know, maybe they did get caught cheating as well. You know, it's something very wrong with this energy that they need to work on themselves quite a lot. Vicious circle, there you go. Pattern of relationship issues, bad habits, a no-win situation. Like I said, they keep repeating the same old dumb thing every time. Same thing. So what else, Spirit? I feel like there's no hope for this person. I know that sounds really, really bad, but I don't feel like there is. So we've got staying flexible and adaptable, keeping an open mind, going with the flow, being teachable. So at the moment, this person is literally going with the flow. They're trying to adapt. Look at this. Karmic cycle. Settling scores in this life, karmic relationship, karmic patterns, negative cycles, personal growth. They're not learning, though, at all. Oh, my goodness. What did I say about karmic justice? I said it twice, yeah? Look what's come out. Karmic justice. Wrongs made right. You will be vindicated, getting what you deserve, learning karmic lessons. And maybe they are. Maybe they are eventually going to learn these lessons and literally take the path that they should be taking. Teamwork, a partnership to complete a goal. Someone will come to your aid, expanding your network, delegating tasks. I did say this energy is talking to other people. So they could be getting some kind of help here from other people, you know, with this situation. Because we do have woman on the back of the deck. Female friend enters your life, a female romantic interest. A woman will assist you, a woman will play a key role. So this could be what the problem is. They keep straying off the path. I don't know why I'm hearing this energy, like, looks at the opposite sex as being like a shiny new toy or an object. You know, it's like it's all glittery and gold and it's exciting. Yeah. Anyway, ask a question, group three. It doesn't have to be about this situation. It could be about anything you want. Ask it out loud or think about it. Let's see what Spirit says. So for group three, please, Spirit. So we've got a few here. So you've got, in a few months, trust your inner voice. Your intuition will be your guiding force. Not in this lifetime, which is very weird. The time has come to let go of this situation and allow your angels to show you the way. And then something else in a few weeks. You have come far on your journey and you will soon see what you have accomplished. So there is something going on with you, group three, okay? You may have had quite a few questions there, but don't forget, Spirit's picking up on your energy here. So there's something that's been triggering you or playing on your mind recently. So literally, Spirit has answered you in, say, regards to those three things maybe that's on your mind, or a couple of things. Okay, so you've got in a few months, something definitely not in this lifetime, and then in the next few weeks, okay? So I'm going to leave it there, group three. If you like this video, please hit like. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. Love to have you. And thank you for staying and watching, guys. I appreciate all of you. Much love.